Hi, I'm Jamal Chandler with Cboe Global Markets, and this is Volatility 411 for Thursday, September 24th. 6 days to go until the end of the quarter, and September's been a rocky month. The S&P 500 index is down 7% month to date. We still don't have a stimulus package. Of course, that affects a lot of Americans and a lot of businesses. The airlines, for example, their funding runs out at the end of the month, and they potentially will have to furlough and or terminate thousands of employees. So it's a situation that bears watching. Initial jobless claims this morning unexpectedly rose to 870,000. That weekly number has been fluctuating a good bit, much like the market recently. It's interesting. On the flip side, we saw strong August new home sales data. This is the fourth month of advancement, and home builders have been relatively strong. We actually saw futures rise on this number. So as I sit here, volatility is interesting. VIX is at the 29.87 level, just below 30. We noted last week the shift in the VIX futures curve, as November is the highest peak, about an 85 cent difference between Oct and Nov as I sit here. My colleague Kevin Davitt in the Options Institute did a great job of highlighting this in the volatility newsletter that came out on Tuesday the 22nd. So we're in this area between the stimulus package and the election, with a potential Supreme Court judge nomination in between. You can expect things to be choppy. Before I go, one housekeeping item. I would like to highlight the fact that Cboe introduced S&P 500 ESG options, cash settled options on the index, ticker SPESG. My colleague Matt Moran did a great job of putting together a blog on the Cboe website, so check that out when you get a chance. That's all for Volatility 411. I'm Jamal Chandler. Have a great trading day.